$75 million.
Wow, I like the way you said that, 75.
Well, I can relate, you know.
That, you know, what an incredible story.
Incredible.
Yeah, overcome, like you said, you see the vision and you get to it.
It's just motivation, determination, vision, and you just have to have it.
Yes.
You know, it's so easy to fall off course, but if you just stay focused. It sounds so cliche.
It's very true.
But it's true.
It is very true, yeah. Jim. You're a real inspiration yourself there, Jim.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, Jim. Guys, I now welcome to the show. It's our contestant number three, a beautiful little princess, another beautiful little girl. Her name is Mia Kabul. She is here, contestant number three. Welcome to the show again, Mia.
Thank you.
Looking so lovely in pink.
Thanks.
Are you ready to do your audition?
Yeah.
All right. Lights, camera, action.
But before I do it, I just want to thank you for letting me be on the show.
Oh, you are so welcome. You're welcome here anytime.
And I'd like to thank everybody who voted for me that last week. It means a lot to me.
That is wonderful, Mia. Mia, you are a beautiful person. And you know what? You got a lot of votes, and you deserved every one of them. And you have a great audition.
So, it's the first day of school, and I don't know what to do. Maybe I can ask my friend Sarah. She'll know what to do. Sarah, what can I do? It's the first day of school, and I don't have any friends. Maybe you can go to me with art. I didn't sign up for art. I signed up for music. Do you have any friends in music? No, not even one. I know. Maybe at recess we can have a best friends club, and then we can have so much friends, more than anybody.
Fabulous! Not only did she play one character, she played two. That is amazing, Mia. That is very hard to do. That is very hard to do. So you step side to side for each one, and they were very different. That is a lot of talent. You're 7 years old. What made you think of that performance? How did you create that?
Well, I just, like, when it's the first day of school, I feel really nervous. So I just ask a teacher, maybe, to see if the other people can let me play with someone. And so I asked them. I got the idea from the first day.
You are a wonderful, wonderful girl, and I love the audition. Everyone today did an amazing job, and Mia, you did a fabulous job, and I'm so glad you were here, and I hope to have you back real soon.
Thank you.
Aww. Awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, big hand of applause for Mia Kabul. 7 years old and absolutely wonderful. I love her answers. I love her acting, her sweet little face. To vote for Mia, again, thedeniseshow.vividi.com. Voting goes until Sunday, 8 p.m. So we got to get those votes. Thanks again, Mia.
You're welcome.
We have another celebrity inspirational story. This woman is a huge inspiration to myself and to so many. She's Canadian, and we're so proud of her. The one and only Miss Shania Twain. Here's her story.
Anyone who's seen Shania Twain's E! True Hollywood Story knows how much she overcame to get where she is today. Born into a struggling family in Ontario, Canada, Twain, then Eileen Edwards, lost her mother and stepfather in a car accident when she was 21.
Okay. And that is a very inspirational story, Miss Shania Twain. Definitely. Thank you so much for reading that, Emily. All these people today that we're hearing about, I mean, they overcome, they stayed, stuck to their vision, as Maestro would say, another fine Canadian.
Well done, nice
stick
reference.
To your vision.
Yes.
All right. That is definitely the motto of today's show. We have the MMG Spotlight News. We do. We've got so many amazing, I mean, you guys are MMG. Everyone here is MMG, and it's just absolutely amazing to be a part of it. The MMG Spotlight News today is going to be featuring three incredible MMG stars. First, we've got the fabulous Casey Chegg. She is featured in 10 pages of Maxim. She's not just a Maxim girl. This girl is fabulous. She's an actress. She's a model. I think she even sings. Mm-hmm. She's absolutely incredible. Beautiful girl. We're so proud of her. We've got the one and only. I actually had a chance to work with this young boy. He's incredible. He is so funny. And he's got like the spirit of an older man. He absolutely blows my mind. His name is Daniel Devenere. And he has just completed his new video at George Canyon, Better Be Home Soon. So we're going to take a little peek at that now.
Something's got a hold on you. It's pushing me aside. See it stretch on forever. I know I'm right for the first time in my life. That's why I tell you. Better be home soon. Stripping back the coats, lies and deception. Acting nothingness, like a week in the desert.
Daniel, way to go, Casey. And now our third MMG spotlight is on our star. His name is Ty. He's featured in Rihanna's new Kodak commercial. Let's check it out. I think he is actually on her iPhone. Watch closely.
Not bad. I want you to love me. Look at that. Like I'm a hot guy. Now here's mine. Don't be too late.
Yes, so that is the MMG Spotlight News. We're going to bring it back to the round table with my special guest co-host. How are you guys feeling? What did you think of the performances?
Everybody is so darn talented.
Yes.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
The imagination just blows me away.
I know.
And I think, you know, like you said it perfectly. You just have to hold on to it because it's so easy to lose that imagination.
That's right.
And then when we see it, you know, blatantly in front of us, we admire it. We celebrate it.
And what a lot of courage, too. I mean, these kids are young, yeah. Like 10 and 7 and 9, and they're doing incredible things.
I almost don't want to look while the performer's doing the performance because I feel like, you know, I'm going to make him or her nervous. And I think, well, wait a second. These are performers at such a young age. So, I mean, if I look, it won't kind of throw them off.
And it didn't. They didn't even know. Like, they were right in the zone.
Yeah.
Absolutely wonderful. What do you think, Emily?
Competition for them. If they were in my age category, I'd be
be a little intimidated.
Probably.
They are all fabulous, very creative. Let's talk a little more. There's so much going on. We got into a little bit, had a little taste of where you've been. You've been to Halifax with Jimmy Walker, Ed the Sock. Life doesn't get much better.
Can't get it out of my head.
Does he still say that?
He did for the infomercial.
Wow.
And I'm thinking, well, you know, does he still want to say it? Who knows if he still wants to say it. But for the infomercial, it was part of it. But it was amazing because, I mean, I didn't grow up with Jimmy Walker per se, but being a TV guy, I know the reruns. And I used to watch Love Boat too, right? So I mean, he guest starred on that. Jimmy Walker's great.
That is incredible. Yeah. And what about Ed the Sock? Like, what does he really like to work with?
He's great. He's very witty. He's very quick, as you can imagine. I mean, you know, live TV, TV, radio, whatever it is,
right.
You have to be very quick. And if you're dealing with people like guests and any sort of media, I mean, he's just the quickness and the wittiness and just the spontaneity of where he comes up with things to say and do is just is surreal.
Yeah, he's definitely witty, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Couple of little jokes there. I think he always has a punchline.
Always a punchline. Some of them not so nice. Some of them, you know, sometimes are crude. But it's always the spontaneity that really, I think, makes people laugh the most.
How do you find that about comedy? Like, are you one of those people that kind of looks for that, the rude punchline? Or how do you kind of go about it?
I'm a big fan of Zach Galifianakis.
Okay.
And I love Jim Carrey.
Yes.
Galifianakis has the very sarcastic, dry And it's all in the delivery. So, I mean, it doesn't matter. Personally, I don't think it matters if you say something crude or not. It's how you deliver it.
Right.
And it's based on context, too. But Galifianakis and Carrie.